Despite the growth in smartphone popularity, despite its importance, when it comes to productivity, PCs or laptops are still the crux of the matter. Everyone needs a PC, be it a serious gamer, a Netflix binge watcher, an IT employee, or a college student. Fun fact, I did my degree in IT, so laptops were a must, you know, to demonstrate programs to professors, collaborate for projects and so on. But I did not want to buy one because I had just spent around 70,000 on this desktop PC. But trust me, getting through those 4 years of dodging professors was probably the hardest thing I've done in my life. So yeah, everyone needs a PC, not just a regular one, but a good, a modern one. You know, the difference between a traditional and a modern PC, that's where people go wrong. Even many tech-savvy people get deceived and make bad choices. So instead of just giving you a list of laptops with links in the description, I decided to make this sort of an awareness video, a detailed laptop buying guide, so you won't need anybody else to decide for you. Of course, giving a list of laptops will get me some commission, but that's for another day. Today, we are talking tips, list of mistakes to avoid, things to look for in your next PC, and so on. My name is Ashwin Sundar, this is Technology Jog, and let's get started. Before we begin, a huge shout out to our sponsor, Capes India. Capes India makes these really cool skins, completely changing the look and feel of your device. Of course, they also protect your device from scratches and dings without adding any noticeable weight or thickness to the device. Capes skins come in a variety of colors and textures, so there is something for everyone. They're available for a range of devices, including laptops, smartphones, headphones, and even cameras. So do check out Capes India, link in the description. Use the promo code TJOG to get 10% discount. Now, the moment I said modern PC, I'm pretty sure you assumed we are gonna talk about expensive PCs, right? Well, guess what? You were totally wrong about that. Guys, when I say modern, it's not really about the specs. It's not about sporting the latest high-end processors or graphics cards. It has absolutely nothing to do with specs. It has everything to do with the experience. Let me tell you something. Things have gotten a lot better over the past few years. We can now expect a really good user experience in almost every price segment. 50,000 rupees? Possible. 40,000? Possible. 30,000? Yes, possible. So yeah, regardless of the price, there are a few things you need to look for in a laptop. Number one, short boot times. Number two, long battery life. And number three, a good form factor. Number four, speed. And it shouldn't slow down in a couple of years. So yeah, just a few basic requirements that make sure the user experience is not compromised in any way, to make sure your productivity is not hampered. Now, there is one thing that helps with all the four requirements I listed out: SSD or solid state drive. Guys, buying a laptop without an SSD in 2020 is the biggest mistake you need to avoid. It's a crime, it's a sin that may be forgiven by God, but definitely not by your laptop in a couple of years. If you purchased a laptop for less than 50,000 rupees before 2019 or 2018, chances are it has a conventional hard disk drive or HDD, and chances are it has become quite slow now. Now, that doesn't happen when your laptop has an SSD. From the outside, it looks like, you know, the only difference between HDD and SSD is speed, but trust me, that's just one of the many perks. I'm pretty sure you all have faced hard disk failures at least once or twice in the past, be it in your laptop or an external hard drive. Just go to the comment section and let us know what data did you lose and how important they were to you. Well, in my case, I lost over 10,000 personal photos and a few hundred videos. All the memories captured between 2009 and 2013, gone, erased. Now, this kind of failure is almost non-existent on SSDs. I mean, the frequency is a lot less. The reason why conventional hard drives fail relatively quick is because they have moving parts, and we cannot be sure that our laptops will always be handled with utmost care. Because let's be real, accidents do happen. Just a single drop will have considerable impact on a hard disk drive, but not on a solid state drive, because SSDs have no moving parts. Next up, speed. SSDs can be up to 50 times faster than HDDs. And the difference in speed is actually something you will notice literally everywhere. Anything you do on your laptop feels considerably faster. Let's take gaming, for example. You would think the only thing that can make your experience better is a better graphics card, right? But the fact is, the loading screens, which I know you hate looking at, will disappear quickly only if you use an SSD. Even launching a game can be many times faster. And Windows updates, the most annoying thing ever. I'm sure all of you feel that way. With an SSD, updates won't take too long. And of course, transferring files is also much, much faster. Now, these are things that are obvious, that can be seen and felt by you. But there are other hidden advantages too. SSDs require less power to run, so it can technically improve your laptop's battery life by a bit. SSDs are much smaller and lighter than HDDs, which means the laptop will also be probably thin and light, or the manufacturer would have more space for other important components, like a better cooling solution or a higher capacity battery. Guys, basically, SSD is both directly and indirectly responsible for making your experience with your PC a whole lot better. So, do not buy a laptop without SSD. In fact, if you have an old laptop and want to upgrade to a new one, first think about why you want to upgrade. If it's because the laptop has slowed down, believe me, you don't have to upgrade. All you need to do is replace the HDD with SSD. In fact, if the laptop has a DVD drive by any chance, then you can just replace the DVD drive with an SSD using a caddy or an adapter. Just watch some YouTube tutorials or take it to the local computer shop, they'll get it done in no time. If you choose to replace the DVD drive, it means you will have both HDD and SSD in the system. But make sure Windows is installed on the SSD. That's what helps the system run much faster. A 256 GB SSD costs less than 3000 rupees. Adapter might be around 500. Also, if the laptop has a free RAM slot, you could add a 4GB or 8GB RAM stick. That's another 2 to 3000. Maybe even replace the battery if the battery life is terrible. So you can do all of this under 10,000 rupees. Breathe a new life into it and I guarantee it will easily last at least another couple of years. Even after that, the laptop will be very much usable as a secondary laptop or for your parents or children, whatever. You won't have to get rid of it. Now, one downside to using an SSD is that the capacity will probably be smaller. If a laptop has an SSD variant and an HDD variant at the same price, the SSD variant will likely have only half or a quarter of the storage capacity of the HDD variant, because SSDs are way more expensive. You will still see a minimum of 128 GB on laptops under 35,000, and beyond that price, look for 512 GB SSD. For productivity, I think it's more than enough. You're gonna watch movies on Netflix and other OTT apps. You're gonna listen to music on apps like JioSaavn, Spotify, etc. So the only thing you need storage for is games. And a 512 GB SSD can comfortably store 5 to 10 games, even AAA titles. The next thing you need to make sure of is the laptop shouldn't weigh more than 2 kgs. Or consider skipping your workout for the day. Guys, if it has some additional special functionality like 2-in-1 or dual displays or something very cool like that, or if it's an affordable gaming laptop, in those cases, a bit of extra weight is acceptable. But for a conventionally designed laptop, anything over 2 kgs is not recommended. Now, it would be wrong to assume these kinds of features were available only on ridiculously expensive laptops. The LG Gram 14 that my cousin has weighs around a kilogram. It's one of the lightest laptops in the world, if not the lightest. And it was around 60K at the time of purchase. And same goes to the Acer Swift 3, I guess, which is also very light. I think around 1.1 kilogram, and it costs under 60,000. And even other modern features like fingerprint scanner, fast charging, these are available on reasonably affordable laptops. I recently purchased the Asus VivoBook X512, which has 3rd generation Ryzen 5 processor, 8GB RAM, 512 GB SSD, a fingerprint scanner, a backlit keyboard, and really thin bezels, which kind of reduces the overall footprint of the device, and it weighs only about 1.6 kilograms. The price? Just 43,000 rupees. And the Mi Notebook 14 that was launched recently has 10th generation Core i5 processor, 8GB RAM, 512GB SSD. More importantly, it weighs just 1.35 kilograms. It has super thin bezels and has the footprint of a typical 13-inch laptop. The price is about 45,000. So you do get such engineering marvels at affordable prices. And that's precisely why you shouldn't be making wrong, terrible choices. Honor also launched their first laptop in India, the Magic Book, which has an amazing display, fingerprint scanner, and even 65-watt fast charging, along with some other cool features. Maybe I will add links to some good laptops in the description. Commission time. Choosing a super heavy laptop with a conventional hard drive, no SSD, without any additional handy features like fast charging or fingerprint scanner is still fine, but spending anything over 35 or 40,000 rupees on it would be absurd. For those with a higher budget, there are other advanced features you need to look for. For example, my LG Gram 15 is probably the lightest 15.6-inch laptop available in the market. It's made of super high-grade materials with military standard 810G certification and has a wonderful touchscreen display. Other things you need to look for include Type-C port, fast charging, instant power on, backlit keyboard, Wi-Fi 6, and so on. A full-fledged productivity laptop, you know, around 1 lakh rupees or even more than 1 lakh rupees, which is not meant for gaming, those laptops should preferably have eSIM support, precision touchpad, convertible option, or any other unique form factor and more unique features. Next up, processor and RAM. I don't really want to go deep into this part because this is a very basic guide focusing more on the user experience regardless of the price. But in short, the bare minimum you need to have is 4GB RAM. If you're spending over 34 or 35,000, definitely look for 8GB RAM. It's a little hard to find, but there might be other compromises, but that's totally fine. But anything over 40,000 rupees, 8GB RAM is a must. Similarly, when it comes to processors, this is the basic guide to keep in mind. It's not just about the processors. Don't ignore which generation the processors belong to. Some newer low-end processors might be better than some older high-end processors. So do your research when you have multiple laptops in mind with different processors. And of course, if you need a gaming laptop, along with all other features we have discussed so far, you have to spend at least 60 to 70,000 rupees. However, with some compromises here and there, you can get a good gaming laptop that can handle AAA titles for about 50 to 60,000 rupees. Compromises include bad form factor, like the laptop might be very thick and heavy, around 2.5 kgs. But yeah, 50,000 is the minimum you need to spend for a proper gaming laptop. It's common to see GTX 1650 graphics card in that price range. Between 60 and 80,000 rupees, look for 1650 Super, 1650 Ti, and even 1660. Between 80,000 and 1 lakh rupees, 1660 Super and 1660 Ti can be found. The reason I'm giving this kind of a guide is because there are some overpriced laptops out there which you might accidentally buy without doing proper research. Look at this, the Dell G3 with GTX 1650 for 82,000 rupees. That's ridiculous. Now, have a look at the Acer Aspire 7. Almost identical specs. The only difference is the Dell laptop has an additional 1TB HDD on top of the 512GB SSD. But would you want to spend 12,000 rupees extra for the 1TB hard disk? I don't think so. Gaming is our priority here. Similarly, look at the ROG Strix laptop, GTX 1650 Ti for 95K. HP's Omen laptop has 1660 Ti and costs 86,000 rupees. Of course, the ROG Strix has a superior processor and a higher capacity SSD, but chances are games would run better on the 86,000 rupee laptop. Of course, the ROG laptop satisfies some use cases like 4K video editing. So I'm not saying these laptops are overpriced. I mean, it's overpriced for your use case. You know, you want to play games, then you should look for something that's good for games and ignore other features you may not even require. So basically, when it comes to processor, RAM, and graphics card, think about your usage, your use case, and decide accordingly. Anyway, check out the description for some good laptops in each price segment. Overall, the key is to look for a specific set of features, modern features, that will enhance your everyday experience. in both tangible and intangible ways. Features that will help you get work done a lot quicker, no matter how much or how little you spend on the PC. So, I hope you found this video useful and informative. If there is anything else you wanna know, any query regarding how to select the right PC / laptop for your usage, do let me know in the comment section. We'll get back to you as early as possible. That's what I was about to say. Thanks for watching. This is Ashwin from Technology Jog signing off. Take care and stay safe. Do I look depressed or do I need to smile more in my videos? That's a complaint I've always heard from you.